Hey, I'm here with Valerie, and she's doing a Gong Immersion today. This is a community event that's offered here in Steamboat, Colorado. Tell us a little bit about it.
We're going to play some planetary gongs for the full moon, help all these beautiful people balance their energy. We're here at Neptune Float Spa in Steamboat Springs.
And what does it mean to balance the energy in terms of the full moon?
Well, we can always balance our energy, right?
Right.
But the full moon is a nice time because it's a time of bringing things to fruition. So we can, and there's a lot with this particular full moon, so we can take the energy and feel more balanced, more in line.
Excellent.
Help us move forward.
Well, thanks for allowing me to share this with you.
Thanks for coming.
How did you find out about these gongs? These are from Germany?
They are. They're pasty gongs.
Pasty
they're planetary gongs.
All right.
I believe they're the only company that makes planetary gongs. I'm not certain on that.
And tell me,
so
what does that mean
each
for a planetary gong?
Gong is tuned to the cosmos, basically.
Okay.
So sun and
this one, sun
moon,
okay.
Neptune, Venus. Mm-hmm. So, you know, the very smart mathematicians, mm-hmm. Pythagoras, right?
Okay.
Kepler. They are the ones that came up with what those sound of the cosmos sounds like to the human. And then
okay.
the smart men in Germany put them into gongs or tuning forks.
Now, is this based on, for instance, the size of the planets?
Size, I guess, rotation, all
sure.
of that.
Okay.
So, yeah.
Very cool. What inspired you to be there?
The sound bath.
Yeah.
Like cleansing, just like you would take a bath in the water, you take a bath in the sound, and it's healing on mm-hmm. so many levels.
Does that help you reset, or is it more about the meditation that you do while you're there listening to it?
I think it's more of a reset, but
yeah, there's definitely an energetic benefit from it that, you know, kind of syncs up the systems of the body. I mean, it definitely the energy that flows through us when we get into that much sound. And sound from the gongs are made of specific metals. So when they're hit, you know, it kind of just, the sound is like its own entity, as you could tell since you were there. But I think that alone just helps our bodies kind of sync up.
And in terms of a community event, what does community mean to you?
For me, just bringing like-minded people together and sharing a hobby or a passion and connecting on a deeper level. I feel like a lot of times in our society it's more just on a surface level, so it's nice when you can go deeper than that.
Right on.
Yeah, especially we live in a tourist town, high tourist town, so for us locals it's really nice when there's these events that like we get to see all of our favorite familiar faces and kind of come together. So the gong bath I know is a huge staple for me because it's every month because it flows with the moon. And it's awesome.
So it also allows you to connect with your friends at that event too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Exactly.
And then what about someone like me that's an outsider that's coming for the first time to this community? How does that kind of mesh and integrate with the community to, you know, host an open event like that?
You get a taste of what this place has to offer. I mean, how many gong baths have you been to?
That's true. I've never
and
been to one.
How
never
many,
heard of one.
And you've been to a lot of places, right?
This is true.
So
yeah.
this is,
yeah.
you know, maybe unique to the type of people that live in this area or
yep.
that are,
nice.
You know, are like-minded people and feeling like you're a part of something that's bigger than you.
That's so cool. And what do you think is the best piece of Steamboat that makes it so open that people are so welcoming here? Why do you think that culture exists?
Well, I think the people are what makes Steamboat awesome. But also just people move here for similar reasons. We all really appreciate nature and the beauty that's in our backyards, utilizing it and, yeah, doing fun things.
So, and how long have you been doing this?
Playing gongs?
Yeah.
Well, I've owned gongs for a while. We opened the gong studio here in April of 2015.
Oh, pretty recent.
So
okay. That's a sizable investment, I have to imagine.
It is. It yeah. is. I had a teacher and a massage therapist who had a couple gongs, and I always wanted to have some, and so I had a few in my home, and my dream was to have a gong studio, and then we also opened the float spa
Very
at the
cool.
same time.
So the community can come in here and hear the gongs, and they can float, which, tell us what a float is.
You float in 900 pounds of magnesium sulfate, and
okay.
which is Epsom salts,
okay.
and... about 10 inches of water, and it provides a solution that fully supports you, so you're fully supported, able to relax in a way that you haven't before.
Kind of like being in the womb. So for someone to get better knowledge about this, are they supposed to study astrology or something else?
Yeah, I mean, I do. I play the gongs based on astrology.
Okay.
I don't consider myself an astrologist, but I dabble in astrology, and that's how I play the gongs. Not everybody plays them that way.
So, of all the different events that you do here, what is the one inspiring reason that this stands out in the community and that you come every time and do this event?
Because not everybody can afford to have gongs, right? And to have a space where you can have them and to be able to provide that. And that was one of my dreams. That was my goal. I love the gongs. I love the way they feel. I get to sit here and play them all day. And I wanted to be able to experience that.
That's awesome. So, what is the most difficult piece about holding a community event? What do you always struggle with or try to do better?
Well, I guess getting the word out. And then we do a good job of getting everybody in.
You had a full class.
Yeah.
Full room, yeah.
We've had 35 in here.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah, it's tight. So I'd say that's our biggest challenge is space, but
okay.
Small town, right?
Cool. And so, if anyone was out there that was listening and watching you, and you had a word of advice to give them about starting an event in their town, what would that be?
I guess I would say see what's available and what's not, and see what the niche is. So there are other people in town who have gongs, but there aren't other people who have a ton of constant ability to come and hear the gong. So I think that's what we provide that's unique. So look for what you can provide that's unique.
Cool. So basically an opportunity in the community to fill a void and fill a gap.
Yeah.
For needs. Yeah.
Yeah. And I think the other thing is talking to locals and what do they want to see come to your town, especially if it's a small town.
Yeah. Well, something like this, I could certainly tell you, I would never know that I would want to do it. But having experienced it, this is a very cool community. This is
it's
a really great show that you put on. I think all of the experience was something that I could not have been explained if I just read an article.
Right. No, people, you have to come experience. Yeah.
So thanks. Join us next time for another episode of The Dice, the Daily Inspiring Community Event. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.